My father gave me very few presents, but he gave me one very important one. It was a crystal set. A crystal set was a toy for kids during World War II because there were no other toys available. Everything was going to the war effort. But he gave me a crystal set and I built it, wound the copper wire, put the aerial on the roof, and I only got one station. And it was this incredible race music station. Race music was the original music before rock and roll. It was a blues station, and that's all I got. And I would listen with my earphones in bed to some of the greatest blues singers of all time. People like Big Bill Brunzi, John Lee Hooker, Muddy Waters. And there was a song that I remember during this time. It was "You Upsets Me, Baby" by B.B. King, and it was kind of dirty. But I didn't know what dirty was, but I knew I shouldn't be listening to this because they were talking about busts and waists and sex. But I didn't know what it really was all about. But that fascinated me. So every night I went to sleep listening to the best blues on my earphones, curled up in my bed, and it started a lifelong passionate affair with the blues. The next thing that happened that's kind of a prelude to my life as a photographer was my father worked with Duke Ellington and wrote songs with him, great songs like "I've Got It Bad and That Ain't Good," some wonderful blues songs for a show they did together. So in my living room were some of the great blues artists. And I was friendly enough with Duke that as a child, my dad would take me to lunch with him and to dinner and things like that, where I saw segregation for the first time at 8, 9, 10, 11, 12-year-old boy, where we'd have to go into Beverly Hills for dinner, and we would have to sit in the back of the restaurant in the dark shadows so that you wouldn't recognize that my father was sitting with a black man. And I was completely devastated by that reality. And that was my first awakening to social injustice. And it changed me forever.